Hello everyone, welcome back to lesson 2 of Python programming series. So in this video I'm going to talk about the variables, So what is mean by the variables now? Variables are usually a reserved memory space that we use to store some information. So for example, let me create one variable, first name, and I want to store a value that is my first name. So here fname is a variable name and it is storing a value dawa. So if I print what is there inside a fname, then if I run this program, you will see that dawa is stored inside a fname. This is a basic idea on how the variables work. This one is just a simple example. The fname is a variable and dawa is a value that is assigned to a variable. Once we create a variable, it will be also assigned with the separate memory address. So to find the memory address, you can use id. So for that, you can use id and pass your variable name here. And if you run, then you will see that the memory address of dawa that is stored inside the fname is at this address. So now when we are declaring a variable, there are certain naming convention that we have to know. It was recommended by the pip8. So pip8 is a style guide for Python code. Let me give you some example. The variable name can be only letters or number or underscore. Only these three are accepted as your variable name. So for example, if I keep one space, maybe like if I write frst first name, and then if I run a code, then you get an error, invalid syntax. This is because variable name cannot include a white spaces. It should be either joined by a underscore. And if I run this program, of course you are not going to see an output, but there won't be any error. This is because we did not include a print statement here. The variable name cannot start with a number, for example one name, and then if I run this code, you will get an invalid syntax. This is because variable name cannot start with a number, but you can embed a number at the end, maybe something like this. Code runs perfectly fine. The next important thing is, whenever you are declaring a variable, then make sure that your variable name should convey some message, or it should be a descriptive. For example, in my case, it's not just a name, it is my first name. So it should look descriptive, and then it should be able to convey some message. So I would always recommend you to define a variable which is descriptive and which should able to convey some message. So it's always better to put a first name than just writing fn. This is because the variable name is descriptive. You should also know that variable names are case sensitive. So for example, if I want to print this and I'm writing frst first name, something like this, you see that the difference is here the variable name f small letter and is also small letter. Here I am including f capital letter and capital letter. So if I run this program, you should get an error. This is because first name is not defined. What I'm trying to say here is the variable names are case sensitive. When you are using a variable name, it should be exactly like how you have defined. So if I run this code, now you will get an output. By the way, you can also start your variable name with underscore. It works perfectly fine. So but when you are calling it inside your print function, you should also use underscore. So if I run this program, it works fine. What if I declare a same variable name? Now if I print what's there inside a variable name, then what do you think it will be printed? Either dawa or karma doji. Now if I run this program, you should see only one name printed, that is karma doji. So this is because like whenever we are creating a same variable name again and again, the current variable name will be taken in by the Python interpreter. You can also delete the variable. So for example, you can also delete, maybe before we print this karma doji, let me also delete this and let me put name, delete name here. So if I run this program, you get an error, name is not defined. This is because the variable name is deleted. So to delete a variable name, you can use a del keyword. These are the basic idea on what you should know about defining a variables and assigning a value to a variable. So in the next session, I'll be talking about what are the different types of data that you can assign to a variable. We'll see you in the next session.